The views expressed in the following program do not necessarily represent the views of this station or its management.
Real People, Real Life is brought to you by these fine sponsors.
All right, welcome back, Real People, Real Life, Wichita, Kansas, America.
America.
Fossa, how you doing, hon?
Great.
You look beautiful, as
Thank
always.
You.
As always.
The crickets.
Yeah. Oh, God. We'll have to tell them about the crickets in a little bit.
Oh, my gosh.
Joe, how you doing?
If I was doing any better, I'd have to be 2 feet. Well, wait a minute. Maybe I am 2 feet.
Wait a minute.
Time for the cabbage soup.
You got some sun. What have you
I
been
did.
Doing?
I was like burning out in the garden.
Is that what it was? Oh, okay.
I mean, like seriously, I wasn't even paying attention. I was just out there gardening. Then I was like, oh crap.
Did
I'm
you do
be
the
pain.
Garden in the new day?
Ticks are insane.
Food gardening.
I didn't even hear about that.
I think it's.
I did anyway, but I didn't hear about that. Is that something?
It's an annual day. Is gardening
it?
In the nude. It is an annual
yeah,
event
it's on
every
the
year.
Huh.
It's on the calendar.
You don't do that?
You know, but I mean, we're all.
Well, I mean, I do anyway.
That's nothing new.
One day.
No, yeah. It's just like, well, no one's out here and no one can see me, so
what
I'm walking
it?
Around.
You know, and you know the minute you say that, one of those spy drones for Google that gets the Google Maps.
Yeah,
it
can do that.
But it's not illegal to be naked. Only
that's true.
Sexual gestures. You can garden.
Like right now out on the street.
That's correct. They
yes.
actually tested that theory.
Yeah.
No kidding.
That's true. There was a
See.
Gentleman about a year ago. Because
yeah.
we talked about it.
A year ago.
And there was a guy that was just walking down the road up
just
near
walking.
Topeka.
Yep.
Okay. Well, go figure.
Go figure, right? And he's too much fluoride in the water up there. Anyway, yeah, and it was a big to-do. I mean, it made it national news about a year ago.
That's
yeah.
pretty funny.
And it's broke down, and we do know now that it is legal to
Absolutely.
To just you
not
know,
wear clothing.
Not wear clothing.
Clothing optional.
Yeah. And I'm like, really? Why
do that all the time?
Why is that? We still have a nude. What is it? You know, a nude facility, whatever they call that in Hutchison, I think. A nude call.
A news camp. I've heard that for years and years and years.
Can't find it. Looked for years.
I know like every single one of those back roads
yeah.
over there.
Hey,
not that I was looking for it.
Do you?
But I used to work over there.
Oh, okay.
And so I'd get bored.
Try to find those.
Like coming back to Heston, so
let's see if we can find those nudists running around. Somewhere.
Yeah,
have
you found them?
I wouldn't want to see.
Huh?
Most of them I wouldn't want to see.
No, and that's the truth.
That's the thing.
That's why I don't have mirrors in my bedroom. You know.
Oh, is that it?
We used to have mirrors on all the closet doors,
yeah.
and I got up one night after I'd been drinking pretty good, and I called the police on myself. It was bad. I had to explain the bullet holes in the closet door.
God, that is bad. That is bad. Well, anyway, so yeah, there goes the whole reason to have a nudist colony if we can just do it anyway.
Well, back when we were doing those calendar shoots
yeah.
in Jamaica at
yeah.
Hedonism, that was, you know, clothing optional too.
Right, yeah.
And that got pretty scary.
To come to work for me. I keep telling her clothes is optional.
Right, clothing optional.
Oh, Lord. Well, you and
That's
I both them. Have you ever been on an international cruise ship?
I have been on an international cruise ship.
Have you been on an international cruise ship?
Only when it had military flags.
Oh, well, yeah, that's right.
Very
different. A little bit different. We've both been on several international cruises. And what happens at the very top level?
I don't know. They wouldn't let me up there.
I was going to say,
because you weren't nude.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the very top level, if you ever go on a cruise and it's considered an international cruise, where is our cruise and travel expert when we need her? Lori,
right.
from the Travel Junkie. We love you. Travel Junkie here in Wichita. I love those folks. And she can tell you, if you're booking a cruise and it's an international cruise, you know, that very top floor on the ship, okay, the top deck is, that's the international deck.
I did not know that.
You did not know that?
No.
That's why they're keeping you off of this.
I guess so. I was scarred bad enough from all the Europeans in Speedos on the
Okay.
No, they dropped the Speedos up there on that floor. Yeah, seriously, international cruise.
Oh, of which I've got a clip.
Oh, good. No, that's right.
You want
to see it?
Yeah, you want to see the clip? Can we put that on in the morning that early?
Would you?
Yeah,
it might wake a few people up.
Should I blur it?
No, maybe
okay.
a little bit. Well, I don't know.
That would be okay.
Has anybody in one of those actual like unitards, but they're thinner.
Yeah, it looks like an Iranian wrestler or something.
Have you seen anybody in one of those yet?
I have.
I have too, in Miami. And
I could have done without that visual.
No kidding.
He had his hair in little ponies, and he was carrying a purse, and he was roller skating in that thing and going through where everybody's eating. I was like, no.
Oh.
Hey.
God. My daughter was like,
vomit if you got.
Sounds like Venice Beach.
This is why I haven't been on any cruises for the last 20 years. It was a lot easier to do when I was in my 20s, you know. And then some of the different places where you know, what is that?
Dock.
I know, yeah. Well, I would just say that when you get on that one little rum runner cruise and you get off the big cruise ship, you get on one of those little boats and they take you to whatever island or this or that, you know, and a lot of those little rum runner cruises are, you know, topless, and, you know, basically topless. And
they encourage it.
Oh, they do, big time. And I just remember going, oh, God, this is interesting. Anyway, but what they don't tell you is that if you're going to snorkel, to watch out for that, you know, for the
coral.
Yeah,
the waves go up and
you come smelling like I'm doing that ever again.
The dumbest thing I ever did snorkeling was when I was in the Red Sea.
Yeah,
and I picked up one of those sand dollars and was like, "Oh, there's cool." It stuck it in my pocket. They're poisonous.
Yeah.
Really poisonous. My whole leg was like swollen for 3 months, probably. It was terrible.
Oh my god!
That gets your attention.
Yeah,
that'll kind of help. Well, I don't know where all we're going to go. We've got so much going on. I know that our guests today are going to be Adam Knapp, okay? And he is in the process of putting together a new film out here in Kansas. And I also think we want to talk to him about the Tallgrass Film Festival, things that he's done. He's been a sports writer. He's done a lot of really cool things, right?
Right.
So we're going to have Adam on in a little bit, and then we'll wrap up this afternoon with a gentleman that's writing a book right now, and it's on depression. And this is something he's been fighting now, Carl, for 20 years. And so he's in the process of finally writing his book. You know, so we just got a lot of cool stuff. And then this summer, you know, I would like to see, you know, what are some of the options other than international cruise ships that people can do here in Kansas, you know, because I certainly would not want our governor to be mad about anybody going on a cruise ship. That's another story. That guy does not like me, I don't think.
Why is that, Robin?
I can't imagine. Probably because I disagree with him on so many things. Is he a good friend of yours?
Brownback?
Uh-huh.
We're close.
Really?
No.
Do tell.
I'll let you know right now, though, that there is a reenactment of him that I am dying to see.
I know.
I heard about this, and it cracks me up with one of our former guests from Gridiron.
Yeah, right?
So I'm curious to actually meet Brownback.
Really?
No.
Okay.
But yes.
Okay, Joe, is he your buddy?
No, I don't know if he's my buddy. He's not a bad guy. He's just too much of a politician.
Boy, that's an understatement.
It's the reality of it. But I don't
have you
know. I don't. Yes, many times. But I don't know of anybody in his position that doesn't become that.
I think that's the problem. They get in, and they've been in for so long.
Well,
sometimes it doesn't take that long.
And sometimes, yeah, I know.
Ask yourself, you know, everybody, it's easy to sit back here and bash every politician. I bash Obama on a regular basis. But in the end, what is their job? Their job is to try to please as many people as possible because that's how they got where they're at, and that's what they were elected to do.
Mm-hmm.
So it's easy to sit here and take snipes at it, but once you're the guy in that position, then you find out it's not so easy to make everybody happy. And what we hurt for in this country is the reluctant leader that says, I'm going to do what's best, whether it's popular or not. And when we had a leader like that, then everybody bashed him that much harder. His name would have been George W. Bush. This man stood his ground against all opposition, and he followed the, you know, right, wrong, or indifferent. He made a decision, and he led. Admiral Nimitz said it best, when you're in command, command. It's not a time for a committee meeting. It's time to make a decision. If it's the wrong one, it'll bear itself out. Now we know which way not to go.
Right.
And all too often, we have people like Brownback who refuse to make a decision because they're too worried about who they're going to upset. And that becomes the problem. There's no party to that. It's not liberal or conservative. It's politicians, any politician. Once they get into that position, that's where they're at. You know, and me, liberal to me is a mental disorder. I've made it very clear. If you think that I should have to pay your way through life, then we have a problem. And that's the liberal mindset. They think government should do everything for everybody. Conservatives, where they fail is they get too religious. I don't care about your religion, but conservatives have it right in that people should be self-sufficient and self-dependent and responsible for their own actions. I mean, right now we have a whole country with Baltimore syndrome. The government is keeping me down. The government's supposed to do everything for me. The government. So when they can't make a racial argument, then it becomes a battle against the police, and it's all excuses for their own bad behavior. Mm-hmm. So their solution is to go out and burn down their own neighborhood, and then we get to depression because now they're depressed because they have no neighborhood. Well, oppression becomes depression when you burn down your neighborhood. That's the nature of things. But how many times have we seen it? And we already know how this movie ends.
I know, right? Okay, what happened 40 years ago today? Was it 40? It was 1970. What happened on 1970 on this date?
I don't know, off the top of my head.
At a university.
I didn't know there was going
to
be a quiz.
At a university.
I'm thinking. Graduation?
No.
Oh, no, Kent State.
Yes.
Was that Kent? Was that in 70?
That was 1970.
Four students. Well, take a good look at Kent State. I'm here with a gun. I'm scared out of my shorts. I got all these angry shooters, and they're throwing things at me. You know, we throw tear gas to try to quell the argument, and they throw it back. And then they're surprised because somebody opened fire. Mm-hmm. Well, it's real easy to point fingers and say, well, that guy's all screwed up, and it's all murder and this, that, and the other. When you're the guy there getting stuff thrown at you and you're armed, This isn't rocket surgery to figure out somebody's going to get scared and shoot. And then once one of them shoots, now the rest of them are scared and they start shooting.
Right. I just find it ironic, you know, that with everything that's going on, and it was literally 1970. Mm-hmm. You know, how many years ago was that? You know, but that's
45.
Back then. Well, yeah. I know.
I have no sympathy for the Branch Davidians. Yeah. At the point that the marshal knocks on the door and he says, I have a warrant, and you put a gun in his face, pretty much anything that happens after that you brought on yourself.
Yeah.
It may have gotten out of hand. Yeah, driving a tank through there was probably a little overboard. They didn't need to do that, but it's immaterial. They brought it on themselves. I got no sympathy for it.
It's just never a dull moment.
This All episode right. brought to you by the United States Defense Department.
We'll be right back. Real people, real life.
Real people, real life is brought to you by these fine sponsors.
Alboro Cafe, like a vacation to Italy, with Wichita's best Italian dining. Open Monday to Saturday. Happy hour Monday to Thursday, 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Enjoy our featured cocktails, lovely wines, and famous martinis. Alboro Cafe.
Your home's in your hands, you build it.
Whether building a new home or remodeling, higher quality, lower cost, You Build It is the best value. YouBuildIt.com.
Your home's in your hands, you build it.
Sometimes simplicity is the key. Buying a car should be one of those times. It should be fun, comfortable, and above all, easy. At Economy Motors, we strive to make it just that. We offer a wide variety of vehicles, all priced $12,995 or under, and we've helped people in all types of financial situations with quality cars and easy financing. Is it your turn yet?
Come see us!
Economy Motors, 2305 South Broadway.
Don't worry, because at Economy Motors, we got your back.
Hammond Liquor, home of the coldest beer in town and the lowest prices store-wide. For all your special events, your friends at Hammond Liquor have what you need, from beer, wines, spirits, champagne, and more. Open till 8 p.m. every Sunday, Hammond Liquor, West Kellogg and Tyler Road. Hammond Liquor, home of the coldest beer in town and lowest prices store-wide, wants to remind you of very important savings days. Wine Day, Tuesdays get 20% off. Beer Day, Wednesdays get 10% off. Microbrews and imports. Open till 8 p.m. every Sunday, Hammond Liquor, West Kellogg and Tyler Road.
Credit King Auto Sales is getting better all the time.
We're doing it better
all the time.
The
King is celebrating 10 years this summer with hot savings, the biggest inventory, and the best deals, plus a party. Credit King Auto Sales, the king of buy here, pay here. No credit, bad credit, no problem. 10-year anniversary savings are going on right now. Don't miss the party May 16th. It's going to be awesome. The King, Credit King, at the King's Corner, 31st South and Broadway. Go creditking.com.
Welcome to Alboro Cafe, where made fresh daily dishes taste as amazing as they look. Soups, salads, sandwiches, appetizers, Wichita's best pasta dishes. Italian dining at its finest. Like a vacation to Italy, here in Wichita, Alboro Cafe.
More home, less money, happy clients? You bet.
Very satisfied. I loved every bit of it. We had a lot of fun together building this house together.
Your home's in your head. You build it.
And Joey.
Hey.
Real people, real life. We're back.
Real.
I know, right?
It was real today.
So. I know. It's kind of been that way a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you're just now kind of catching up with us. So our first guest today, Adam Knapp. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
What's up,
thanks,
Adam?
What's up, Adam?
How you doing? Brody?
I know. You've got so much that you've done. You've been a sports writer?
Yeah, I've been a sports writer most of my adult life.
Yeah. With the Wichita Eagle for a while.
11 years.
Yeah. I think that's probably where I first met you.
Okay.
Okay, but then you did a little stint with Hank and Phil at T95.
Yeah, I had a little show with them for a while.
Those two are great. Love those guys.
Oh, I loved it. Of course, I wanted to always steer the topic back to rock and roll.
Right? Okay, that's okay.
Killed the show, but yeah, great guys. I've worked for the Business Journal. I've worked for Channel 12. Mm-hmm. I started my own paper in Andover. I guess I've been around the block a little bit.
You've done a lot of really cool things. But one of the main projects you're working on right now is a movie. And it's titled Out Here in Kansas. There was an event, there was a fundraiser here recently.
Yep.
And I wished I could have attended, but I didn't find out about it until the day before.
Oh, wow.
Tell me a little bit about the movie and where we're going with this.
You bet. Well, when I was a sports writer, I did a story on a kid from Andover who lost his home in the tornado in 91. Mm-hmm. Lost his father. He was kind of, by his own description, a chubby bookworm, and basically the gist of the story was he had kind of read about how to play football and, followed the technique and did what he was supposed to do and got a scholarship to Southwestern College, and by the time it was all said and done, he became an All-American lineman. And this guy was a stud. My story was kind of, triumph over tragedy. Well, 2 months later, I'm covering a basketball game at Southwestern, and somebody says, hey, your boy Bert's gay. And I'm like, what?
And, didn't see that one.
Of course, my first thought is, well, damn it, why didn't he tell me? That would have been an awesome story. Well, as I mentioned, I started a paper in Andover.
Right.
So that kind of gave me an excuse to reconnect with him. Yeah. He's a physician now. Super, super, super smart guy. And as I'm speaking to him, I realize that not only is he, or at least used to be, a devout Christian. Mm-hmm. I mean, he can still quote the Bible, just verbatim. His old pastor was my old pastor, Joe Wright. My kids went to Central Christian Academy.
Yeah.
My wife at the time and I were members. Uh-huh. And so I thought, well, let's give old Joe a call and see what he thinks about this.
Oh, boy.
That's
and,
fun.
I tracked him down in Florida, where he was living at the time. And, he was great. Pastor Joe is, you can say you don't believe in, he's not politically correct and he's, conservative. And but there's no doubt in my mind that he's a man of integrity and... Mm-hmm. I believe his heart's in the right place. And so as I'm getting off the phone with Pastor Joe, he says, I'd really like to visit with this young man about
so
this.
So he didn't
thing.
Know. When you were talking to him, he didn't know.
Right. No, I called and told him.
Oh, okay.
And this was a guy who had officiated Bert Humberg is the name of the guy. He officiated his father's funeral when he died. He was a big part of their family.
Right.
And so I... told Bert, you know, Pastor Joe wants to talk to you about being gay.
Oh, oh boy.
And Bert said,
a little late.
Sorry. Hey, by the way.
And Bert said, oh man, I would love that. And I thought, ooh, you know, wouldn't I want to be a fly on the wall for that?
Right.
And that's when I started thinking about making a documentary. Mm-hmm. I actually did get them together at the television studio. Uh-huh. Asked them one question, and they went back and forth for 90 minutes.
Really?
And it was awesome. I was smart enough to just stay out of the way.
Right.
And so it's kind of evolved from there. You know, I'd still like to keep it a short. I'd like to focus on Bert's story. Mm-hmm. I don't want to preach to anybody. But you know, I do. I guess I'm a Christian myself.
Right.
I would like to see you know, certain gay people and certain Christians just stop ridiculing each other, because mm-hmm. I do think the whole gay thing, particularly in Kansas, has been way, way, way...
Defeats your argument.
Oh.
They get so ridiculous with it, it defeats the purpose. Yeah.
I believe if Jesus came down here today, he would be like, what the hell is going on in Kansas right now? Why are you treating gay people like this?
Right.
I don't understand. I, you know. So that's kind of the gist of the whole documentary.
Uh-huh. When do you, time-wise, when do you see this being completed?
Well, we're in the middle of a fundraiser right now. Uh-huh. If you go to outhereinkansas.com, you will see our Indiegogo page.
Okay.
You can donate through that. Once we're done with that, we kind of go into it. We've got about, maybe 60 to 75% of our raw footage filmed.
Wow.
Of course, you know how that goes. You keep thinking of stuff you don't have.
Right.
Still going to take a trip to Salina. Still got a trip to Iowa. There's a really kind of difficult shoot that I want to do here in Wichita, so Bert's flying in for that. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, we'd love to be done in time to submit for Tallgrass. I think that's pretty aggressive, but,
yeah.
You know, it's realistic. If we're not done in time for Tallgrass, that's okay. We'll just keep plugging away until I get the best documentary I can possibly get.
Right.
We'd like to keep it a short, which, you know, by definition is 45 minutes or
right.
less. And, you know, I don't want to give people an excuse not to see it.
Right.
Because it's too long or too boring.
Right.
There's a pool table you can include.
He owns a pool hall, pool bar.
Yeah, I have a pool.
Yeah. So.
How's the light in there?
Yeah.
Pretty good. I got a guy in there trying to film. He's putting together a reality show that's going to follow a league team. And, well, you guys met him, Troy.
Yeah.
Yeah, he shot one of the episodes. And, yeah, Troy's working on all of that stuff. So.
Okay. Sticks.
Yeah.
Yes.
You can swing by over there.
So I have a question.
Yes.
Okay, so your film that you're, it's a documentary, right? So, like, how are you approaching this? Like, what angles, like, their family effects or everything? Their involvement in the community, like, the entertainment? Like, how are you approaching it?
When I first started out, I just wanted to tell Bert's story. And I, you know, just wanted to kind of make it a film version of the follow-up article I wrote when I was doing the Andover thing. You know, since then, there's been all kinds of implications politically here. Obviously, you know, we've talked about Brownback and there's just, it seems like every week something changes as far as gay marriage being legal. Pastor Joe, actually, he and Terry Fox back in 2005 were instrumental in having gay marriage illegal in Kansas. I mean, mm-hmm. Pastor Joe's neck deep into this. So I don't know if us, I guess to answer your question is, I want to make it as entertaining as possible. I don't want to get preachy, as I already said. I just want to invoke a conversation. I want to get people talking about it. Yeah, I mean, I will try to remain neutral. I don't believe someone chooses to be gay. I've always thought that, you know, Pastor Joe, I love him. I mean, I really do. I just think the world of him, and I'm not out to make him the villain. Uh-huh. I think in any movie, you usually have a villain and
it's a good guy.
Yeah. But even, you know, think about Star Wars, you know. But yeah. Darth Vader was the biggest mother scratcher in the universe. Right. And even he kind of turned out to be good in the end.
Right.
Didn't he?
Get your Star Wars brain going.
Yeah, yes, I guess so.
I guess the one who's most into Star Wars.
With his dying brother.
Yeah.
He made the right choice.
Right.
Yeah.
Anakin being Anakin first.
Yeah, for that, you know, for that hologram shot on the planet with the little teddy bears.
Which is so lame. Yeah. But I guess my point is, you know, nobody's all good or all bad.
Right.
I'm all bad. I have a whole slew of followers that think I'm all bad.
Well, you offered to let me use your pool hall. You can't be all bad. Unless you plan to kill me.
No, I hope I've killed all people.
I'm sure there's a plan of one go out of dice roll.
Oh, God. Interesting. When you first wanted to do the story, originally the story was just about a young man that put himself through, was kind of like you said, like a nerd, just read his book and ends up, you know, becoming a professional athlete.
Once his football career was over, he knew what he wanted to do. He was accepted into med school at the University of Kansas, and he's a physician now in a hospital in Iowa. But you kind of get the feeling he could have done whatever he wanted to.
Right.
But he's, at the end of the day, he's a man of science, and that was part of the big debate. Pastor Joe obviously is a man of faith.
Yeah, I was going to say, how does that work, Christian?
They could have argued for, you know, for days.
One question.
Until the cows come home.
Yeah, one question.
Well, can I ask?
That must have been a serious question.
What can I ask? What was that
not
question?
Not really.
Did it have to do with religion?
It did not take much. No. No, I think I just asked Bert to kind of give us his background, and I'm serious.
I
do plan on putting the entire debate up online once it's all said and done, because obviously we can't get it all in this documentary, but right. I want people to see it, because I want people to experience what I experienced and thought what I thought, you know.
So. Wow. We're going to take a quick break. You're not going anywhere. You're still sitting there in the hot seat. But real people, real life. We'll be right back.
Real People, Real Life is brought to you by these fine sponsors.
Alboro Cafe, like a vacation to Italy, with Wichita's best Italian dining. Open Monday to Saturday. Happy hour Monday to Thursday, 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Enjoy our featured cocktails, lovely wines, and famous martinis. Alboro Cafe.
Your home's in your hands, you build it.
Whether building a new home or remodeling, higher quality, lower cost, You Build It is the best value. YouBuildIt.com.
Your home's in your hands, you build it.
Sometimes simplicity is the key. Buying a car should be one of those times. It should be fun, comfortable, and above all, easy. At Economy Motors, we strive to make it just that. We offer a wide variety of vehicles, all priced $12,995 or under, and we've helped people in all types of financial situations with quality cars and easy financing. Is it your turn yet?
Come see us!
Economy Motors, 2305 South Broadway.
Don't worry, because at Economy Motors, we got your back.
Hammond Liquor, home of the coldest beer in town and the lowest prices store-wide. For all your special events, your friends at Hammond Liquor have what you need, from beer, wines, spirits, champagne, and more. Open till 8 p.m. every Sunday, Hammond Liquor, West Kellogg and Tyler Road. Hammond Liquor, home of the coldest beer in town and lowest prices store-wide, wants to remind you of very important savings days. Wine Day, Tuesdays get 20% off. Beer Day, Wednesdays get 10% off. Microbrews and imports. Open till 8 p.m. every Sunday, Hammond Liquor, West Kellogg and Tyler Road.
Credit King Auto Sales is getting better all the time.
We're doing it better
all the time.
The
The King is celebrating 10 years this summer with hot savings, the biggest inventory, and the best deals, plus a party. Credit King Auto Sales, the king of buy here, pay here. No credit, bad credit, no problem. 10-year anniversary savings are going on right now. Don't miss the party May 16th. It's going to be awesome. The King, Credit King, at the King's Corner, 31st South and Broadway. GoCreditKing.com.
Welcome to Alboro Cafe, where made fresh daily dishes taste as amazing as they look. Soups, salads, sandwiches, appetizers, Wichita's best pasta dishes. Italian dining at its finest. Like a vacation to Italy, here in Wichita, Alboro Cafe.
More home, less money, happy clients? You bet.
Very satisfied. I loved every bit of it. We had a lot of fun together, building this house together.
Your home's in your hands. You build it.
Welcome back once again. Joey's going, hi, Mom. Welcome back once again to Real People, Real Life. Adam, thank you for staying with us here. I think you had a question, Fossa.
And don't make it one of those. It's going to take like an hour and a half long answer like the one he got.
I can't wait to hear this.
Yeah. It's not that serious. So when you started doing this documentary, were you yourself faced with a lot of controversy from the public or from people helping you fund it?
No, not really. Everyone's...
Did you find support?
Absolutely. Really? In fact, I would say just about 95% of people, even if they don't, you know, even if they're right-wing conservatives and, you know, pray the gay away, that kind of thing, you know, I think even they understand what I'm trying to do. If they believe being gay is a choice, then, I think they're curious at the very least about what I'm trying to do. We, you know, just get the discussion going because, you know, let's say gay is being a sin. You know, is it any worse than, you know, the gamblers and the fornicators?
126 pairs of shoes.
You're going to hell.
That is a sin.
That's who I am. I did not choose to have an addiction to shoes.
That's a sin. That sounds like insanity.
Right.
Yeah.
That sounds like a really big closet.
I didn't have a lot of them, but yeah, see. So, you know, I don't feel like you get to choose who you are. You just are who you are. You build it into a wall?
No. You fill it full of candy, so when the diabetes takes over and your feet are gone, now you don't have to have all the shoes, so you just fill it full of candy.
Oh, my God.
That's like preventative medicine right there. What is that, Obamacare, Joe?
But to expand on your question, it has affected my own personal life. My brother-in-law is a Christian pastor who, you know, goes by the Bible's word, and, you know, he doesn't, I don't think, believe you're born that way. It's affected my life as far as people reaching out to me saying, you know, I've got a family member who's gay, I've got my sister, a brother, my mom the other night, someone Friday night told me their mom was a lesbian and always has been.
Right.
So, you know, is the first rule as a journalist is don't get involved in the story, but, you know, I'll admit I've been really... First time in my career, I've kind of neck deep into this.
Right.
So, you know, you talked about being neutral. I, you know, to the best of my ability, I will. But, you know, hey, it's a movie, right?
Do you yourself get stereotyped because of it?
What do you mean? Do people think I'm gay?
Yeah.
I think probably. I don't know. I'm not gay.
Because you're...
No, not really. You know, we've got an awful lot of support, I think, from the gay community. People do think I'm gay. If that helps the film, then hey.
Then right. I'll do the...
I'll do the Jack Tripper... yeah.
Right? A lot of people don't know who that is. Do you
Research oh, who would be a modern day?
Yeah, I know, yeah.
Yeah. But, you know, Grace I don't think my life's any more difficult than, you know, if you're going to be gay in Kansas, you better be a tough son of a bitch.
Yeah.
You know, that's who I'm looking out for because our whole theme for Friday night was hashtag hug the hate away, which is a play on words for pray the gay away. Because gay people do face hate that straight people do not, particularly here.
In the gay community, I've got comes a stick on a regular basis. It's all lesbians.
Yeah.
You rarely ever see the male variety, but we've got a lot of groups of lesbians come down here and play pool.
No males that you know of.
See, exactly.
I was
going
to say that you know of, yeah.
There are some, but yeah, they're not afraid to tell you about it, but the few that come down there, they're very open about it. But, you know, we don't pick and choose who the customers are,
right,
as long as they behave and follow the rules of the club. But I would argue that there is a choice involved in anything we do. You might have a desire that you were born with to be a certain way, but it is a conscious choice to follow that desire or not. A heterosexual male sees a really good-looking 15-year-old girl. He's real interested until he finds out she's 15. So there's a choice involved. So that's the part of the argument that always seems to get left out. Right, wrong, or different, I don't really care what people do in their bedroom. What the part of, about the whole gay argument that I've never understood, and maybe you can explain, is why do we have to keep having this discussion? I don't discuss everything I do in my bedroom. Why do I need to hear about what happens in yours? I don't care. Really, we've got bigger things to worry about.
I think, you know, the reason it's come up right here, right now, you know, if this was out here in California,
right,
let's face it, but, you know, it's come up with Brownback. You know, there was a law in place that made it illegal to discriminate against protected gay people who were state employees, and that was Kathleen Sebelius's order, and Brownback reversed it. I don't know who told him to do that, but it was so bizarre, and it seemed so mean-spirited that, you know, I think gay people in Kansas are really, really discouraged right now. They want to move. I know they want to move.
Transactions? I mean, how did that get past the people?
I don't know. The first I heard about it was on The Daily Show, because Jon Stewart just...
likes to bash us for...
Well, I mean,
giving fuel for thought.
Absolutely.
It doesn't matter if it's New York or if it's L.A. I mean, I'm seeing more and more national reports of what in the world's going on in Kansas. I mean, we just keep making ourselves look like, you know, really? I mean, I don't have any red shoes that I can click and suddenly there's some wicked witch and flying monkeys and, you know, she probably does. See, there you go. That's the big shoe closet. You know, but I mean, nationally, even in the United States,
we're going against the trend.
Correct.
And I, you know, I think some people are rejoicing about that, saying we've stood our biblical ground. But that's why.
This argument before in history, though, had to do with the school in Topeka. Going against the trend is not necessarily a bad thing.
And continue. I mean,
U.S. versus Brown.
Oh.
Oh.
Yeah.
We historically can say, well, we were making a laughing stock of ourselves, but had we taken that same tact then, discrimination in schools would still be in place.
So you're saying Kansas was progressive back then?
No, I'm saying that debates need to be had. And if we get to worrying about the political view of it, this gets back to politics like I talked about in the first segment. If we get so hung up on what everybody thinks and so afraid we're going to offend somebody, the discussion never happens. The reality is PC has ruined the country. We're so afraid we're going to offend somebody, nobody has any honest discussions anymore. Some people downright need to be offended. That's the way the truth is going to come out. It's just the way it is. And until we warm up to that, I'm okay with Kansas being the laughing stock. Let's get the conversation going.
It's going.
It's going.
It is going.
You know. Kansas just needs to find that Harvey Milk to make things happen the way that they did in California. You know, because without Harvey Milk,
right,
you know, gays would have never had any right or anything else. I mean, people were being killed left and right before he stood up to, you know,
that's all you'd hear about, is like rolling them. That's right. What it was called.
Personally, I think Bert is a outstanding. I know he never signed up to be a spokesman for, you know, or an advocate for, you know, gay rights or just a discussion. But he's excellent. Okay. I mean, so I'm proud that he signed up for it, and I'm just trying not to screw it up.
You know, I think you're right when you said that, you know, this political correctness and everything that we say and yeah. and how we present ourselves is getting a little bit out of hand.
I don't have that filter.
No, you don't.
No, I don't.
You know, but there are people that would lose their jobs, for example, if they gave their opinions of how they really felt about something.
And that's why
I'm self-employed. There you go. Because I would be in a lot of trouble, you know.
And that's why I've almost exactly. bitten through my tongue over
I know.
Here.
That's why you're not going to say anything for a while.
I'm not talking.
So, yeah, we just kind of, where's that roll of duct tape? Duct tape right
Gaff
now.
Gaff tape, even better.
Yeah, duct tape. We need the duct tape. You know, but yeah, wow. you do have to be careful because, and that's what I'm finding, and it's not just in this particular right. subject, but in a lot of subjects. Here in Kansas, you will lose your job.
Yeah.
In no uncertain terms, if you don't go with the political
stand by
flow.
My morals. I cannot work for some place that I right. don't believe in. I will voice my opinion and walk right. away.
And right. by the way, I don't consider myself a liberal. I mean, not really. I mean, yeah. I think I'm liberal Something on else. Some issues and conservative on others, and just yeah. every issue that comes up, I just kind of try to use the brain God gave me.
Right.
And use common sense. I'm a realist.
Yeah.
Sorry. Realist people have the fewest friends.
Exactly.
Really? Well, that explains a lot in my life, okay? I don't see, I mean, there again, we're back to all the labels.
Right.
You
right.
know, the conservative Republican, you know, the whack job liberal, you know. Wow. One of my favorite people that we had on this show was Keen Umber that okay. ran on the Libertarian
amazing.
Ticket. And I, to this day, I still am a Keen Umber fan.
Can't say that I'm not either. I am.
I am.
Really did like that guy, and I mm-hmm. pick up on people's vibes. Mm-hmm. He was like so true blue, like mm-hmm.
he was
real. I mean, of course, he even stated it himself. Like Joe said, he was like, you know, you find yourself, you know, in the position, mm-hmm. and then having to, you know, you only have so much that you can actually do yourself. You have to get it past other people. I mean, you can only do so much. So
I want to see real quick, honest. Adam, how can people, if they want to donate? And again, the title of the documentary is Out Here in Kansas. How can people research what you've done so far and donate? How can we do that?
Well, I guess the easiest way is just go online to outhereinkansas.com. Mm-hmm. Anybody's welcome to call me. Anyone's welcome to email me. I am not hard to reach.
Right.
I will talk to anybody individually. Or in a group, or you know, I'm trying my best to get the word out, and you know, to communicate.
You have a Facebook page?
Yeah, I've personally got one, and of course, and people do reach me through that. Out Here in Kansas, Facebook, Twitter. I think we've got Instagram and those things too, but I'm too old to know anything about those.
Okay, as long as we know, as long as when people ask, we can make sure and tell them how to get a hold of you, and you don't mind if somebody were to call and I say, here's his Facebook, right?
Please do.
Right on. All right, once again, we're going to be right back, Real People, Real Life.
Real People, Real Life is brought to you by these fine sponsors.
Alboro Cafe, like a vacation to Italy, with Wichita's best Italian dining. Open Monday to Saturday. Happy hour Monday to Thursday, 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Enjoy our featured cocktails, lovely wines, and famous martinis. Alboro Cafe.
Your home's in your hands, you build it.
Whether building a new home or remodeling, higher quality, lower cost, You Build It is the best value. YouBuildIt.com.
Your home's in your hands, you build it.
Sometimes simplicity is the key. Buying a car should be one of those times. It should be fun, comfortable, and above all, easy. At Economy Motors, we strive to make it just that. We offer a wide variety of vehicles, all priced $12,995 or under, and we've helped people in all types of financial situations with quality cars and easy financing. Is it your turn yet?
Come see us!
Economy Motors, 2305 South Broadway.
Don't worry, because at Economy Motors, we got your back.
Hammond Liquor, home of the coldest beer in town and the lowest prices store-wide. For all your special events, your friends at Hammond Liquor have what you need, from beer, wines, spirits, champagne, and more. Open till 8 p.m. every Sunday, Hammond Liquor, West Kellogg and Tyler Road. Hammond Liquor, home of the coldest beer in town and lowest prices store-wide, wants to remind you of very important savings days. Wine Day, Tuesdays get 20% off. Beer Day, Wednesdays get 10% off. Microbrews and imports. Open until 8 p.m. every Sunday. Hammond Liquor, West Kellogg and Tyler Road.
Credit King Auto Sales is getting better all the time.
King is celebrating 10 years this summer with hot savings, the biggest inventory, and the best deals, plus a party. Credit King Auto Sales, the king of buy here, pay here. No credit, bad credit, no problem. 10-year anniversary savings are going on right now. Don't miss the party May 16th. It's going to be awesome. The King, Credit King, at the King's Corner, 31st South and Broadway. GoCreditKing.com.
Welcome to Alboro Cafe, where made fresh daily dishes taste as amazing as they look. Soups, salads, sandwiches, appetizers, Wichita's best pasta dishes. Italian dining at its finest. Like a vacation to Italy, here in Wichita, Alboro Cafe.
More home, less money, happy clients? You bet.
Very satisfied. I loved every bit of it. We had a lot of fun together, building this house together.
Your home's in your hands. You bet.
Okay, you guys, we're back once again. Real People, Real Life. You know, people have asked us, and this is true. Okay, people have said, gosh, we want to be in the audience.
Yes.
When we do the show. Thanks, Adam.
Yep, thank you.
Bye, Adam.
See you soon. Why not? We probably should. I'm kidding.
Yeah, can we sell tickets?
That's not a bad idea. That's probably not a bad idea.
Free, but we will sell drinks while you're
there. Yeah, I was going to say.
There you go. Well, we need to welcome our next guest, Bobby Fleming, correct?
Yep. Hi, Bobby.
How you doing?
Good.
Good. Okay, you own BBB.
It's Triple B's Express.
Triple B's Express.
And that stands for Be Safe, Be Smart, Be Responsible.
Right on.
And what we do is we actually are a company that will take you from your house to the bar. And then when you're done, you call us and we'll take you from the bar back to the house. And anywhere in Wichita, it's $25 for up to four people.
Round trip.
Round trip.
That's awesome.
Yeah. I saw that and I thought it was a typo.
I was going to say it's like your best friend, but it's really more like your mother.
Exactly. That's, well, yeah. I mean, and what our mission is to not have people drink and drive.
Right.
And so, and with our company is it takes the guessing game whether you're okay not to drive your truck home or your vehicle home because it's not the bar with you.
Right.
It's back
at home. It's beautiful.
Yeah. I love that.
Yeah. And so.
Can I ask how long does it normally take once you receive the call that they want picked up, or do you give a time?
What we do actually is we can take reservations, and that always helps. You know, like if you know you're going out on a Friday night, give us a call Thursday or something and say, hey, we need to schedule a ride for this time. Mm-hmm. But if you call off the whim, it takes about 20 minutes or so for us to come out and get, and
I'm not going to name the place.
Get you booked up.
But I waited for 3 hours one time.
Yeah, that's
finally sober enough to drive home.
Yeah, exactly.
I was going to say my name. Yeah.
Okay. And then have you know,
usually a vehicle with a little light on top of it.
No. Yeah. Those are the other ones. Yeah, but no, it's and what we've done is we had actually started with a truck, mm-hmm. And then I needed more room, so we bought a small bus, that's a 14 passenger bus, and then I needed more room from that, so I bought a 25 passenger bus. Uh-huh. So we actually have two party buses as well. So we have lights on inside.
It's a party bus. It's a party bus. Bar and back?
Not for $25.
Oh, okay.
No.
Yeah. You don't get a stock car for $25.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Right in the truck.
Yes, in the truck. Yeah. And we also have just purchased a stretch limousine as well. About
is it pink?
No, it's not pink.
What color is it?
No, it's white.
Nice.
So yes, thank you. So, but yeah, and that's what our mission is you know, to have people don't drink and drive. You know, just think just a little bit beforehand.
Yeah.
You know, reserve your ride and.
A little bit of drink each rider. One drink each. That's the cost.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Of no DUI.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
$25 cost? For four people.
Up to four people.
Man, that's awesome.
Yeah. We always tell people.
I would never drive again.
We always tell people it's $25 plus big fat tip because I'm a little guy. And,
you know, right. So, yeah.
But yeah.
We used Bobby this past year for Zubilee. Uh-huh. We picked us up at home in Old Town, took us to the zoo, and once it was over, I think you picked us up about maybe it was 1 o'clock in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
We were plowed. We had no right walking.
Right.
Yeah.
That happens at Jubilee.
It does. I've seen a lot of things. I could take it three shows.
Maybe we should do a ride along some night.
You could. Yeah. More than welcome to.
Gordy and I are working on doing a ride along with Wichita PD.
Oh yeah.
Yours sounds pretty entertaining too.
It is. Yeah. It is very entertaining. Yeah. I wish I had cameras in my car, but a lot of people would, you know. But what happens in my car stays in my car.
Oh, God.
That's right. That's right.
Can you imagine, though? There really was that show.
Ken's Confessions.
Taxi Cab Confessions.
Yeah.
I think that'd be great. Yeah. I think maybe you might want to think about that.
Let's work on it. I'm good.
All you do is need to get one of these caps right here. And you're good to
go. And everybody just sign their name.
That would be good.
Hand them a clipboard.
Before they get drunk, sign their name.
I'll be back to get you in a couple hours.
So how far out do you go?
It's $25 in Wichita, and then and then the farther that you go out, it's extra $10.
Okay.
So for us, from here to Hutch, it's $100, and we also do casino runs as well, and that's $35 for up to four people. And what happens is there's another service in town that will give you a ride with the you have to push the button, a little thing on your telephone. Yeah, I won't mention the name of the company, but the nice thing about it is they will get you out to the casino, and once you're out there, you're stuck out there because they won't go back out and pick you back up. So we get a lot of those rides from those people who use service to get out there, and they have no way of getting back in town.
What's the time frame on the return? How many hours can they be? Get 2 days? Is it going to come back and get them?
Oh, yeah. No. That's a very good question. If it goes over another day, then you get charged extra. Yeah. So, but no, we have several people who
get lost at the casino.
Yes, yeah, and we'll call us the next day.
I'm friends with some of these people. That's yeah. why I asked.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Yeah.
I was thinking. Oh, okay.
Yeah, it happens.
Yeah, so,
but well, yeah, it's a lot of fun. Yeah, they are.
Oh, the debauchery.
Oh, so just give me your favorite story. You don't have to use names.
No, I wouldn't even know where to start. I mean, there's several of them. I could use all his, for example.
His are always
I'm not sure as far as, I mean, you know, I had this one gal who we actually took her for her bachelorette party. And she came out of the house and she was all happy and go lucky and excited. And we went over to another house where they were having a party. And she goes in all happy and she comes out all happy. And just jumping around, hammered, she gets in the back of my truck and just curls into a ball. I'm like, what is her problem? And the guy in front of us said, well, she can't drink and then ride home with anybody. I'm like, you didn't mind going to tell me this before she gets in my car? Yeah, because she gets car sick.
After she gets drunk. She can't sit in the back seat after she's drank.
That's fun.
And so all the way home, I got the windows down, and I'm just like, okay, don't do it. And nobody's ever has gotten sick.
Like they have in the airport. Yeah,
I do. I have a couple of them. Yes.
You better keep those handy.
Oh, they're there. And then once she went home, it was lights out for her. But it was funny. I told the guy, I was like, didn't you want to tell me that? She can't puke in my car. Yeah.
Nice to know.
Yeah. It's like, yeah.
So, how can people get a hold of you?
We can call our office line, which is 316-304-2771.
Okay.
We have Facebook page.
Look right in the camera and say it again.
316-304-2771. Okay. And we have a Facebook page, which is Triple B's Express.
And when you say Triple B's.
It's the word triple and then B-S Express.
Triple B.
And then we have our website, which is www.triplebsexpress.com.
Okay.
So we have a picture of our limo in there and our buses in there. And so, and our buses are good for like bachelor parties, bachelorette parties,
right.
You know, all that good
groups.
Stuff. Concerts, you know.
Concerts.
Mm-hmm.
And his equipment is very well maintained.
Right.
Yes. Because
I wouldn't ride with him.
Yeah, I know.
and I help maintain some of this stuff too. So.
Yeah.
He's a huge help.
Yes, you can.
Really?
In our buses and limos. The truck you cannot.
Well, I'm riding in the truck.
No, you can't. You cannot. No, I'm sorry. It stinks.
We used you when we had our trip to Chicago a year and a half ago.
Mm-hmm.
Took us to Newton. Five of us.
For the train.
Took us up there. Dropped us off at 2 o'clock in the morning for the 3 o'clock train.
Yeah.
That was another time when we thought, well, we got a 12-hour train ride ahead of us. Let's get drunk.
Heck yeah.
That's what I sleep it off on the train, wake up, and start all over again when we get to Chicago.
Yeah. Plan. Oh.
That's fun.
And this is a
have
great
you ever taken a train?
Uh-huh.
Have you?
Yeah, yeah.
Where'd you go?
Chicago before. Like, you can go to Lawrence. You can go the other direction. My buddy lives in Albuquerque. So you can start drinking that way.
Oh, really?
And, like, we picked up in, like, Albuquerque, man.
I would like that.
Well, you can take it all the way to Los Angeles, but it's
yeah,
fun.
Yeah, you can. That's actually where I...
No, I did not
it's
know
fun.
That.
I took one. Just take it to Kansas City, even. Yeah. Of course, what? You get there at, like, 6 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
I took one to St. Louis when I was little. Uh-huh. And when we hopped on there, like, well, like you did, like, 2:30 in the morning, and it was, like, probably 300 Boy Scouts.
Wow.
And it smelled just absolutely... It was horrible. Oh, yeah. It all was sweaty. It was like, ugh. That was a very long trip. But
so the most hilarious story then, the most hilarious story is the young lady that forgets to tell anybody.
Yeah, that she can't ride home after she's been, you know, after she was.
That's my sister, and it makes some of my best friends so mad because she gets to sit up front and they have to sit in the back.
Yeah.
Yeah, shotgun's a big issue when
girls. Yeah. It is. That's true. It is.
It's usually
do
women.
Call shotgun?
Oh yeah, all the time.
In the
oh,
truck, right?
Yeah,
shotgun.
In the truck. Yeah.
For the record, no, I just called it.
Yeah.
For when I go.
There you go.
You can't do that. You can't. No. You can't do that.
You know who you are. I was gonna say. We may have to do a big group party now.
We could do that.
We'll be
calling. Go in the limo and yeah, we can do that.
On that one too.
Yeah. So
is that limo?
Go ahead,
is that going to be the same price?
Okay.
The limo and the 14 passenger bus are both $100 an hour,
okay.
And then large bus is $150 an hour. But what we do differently is, like, say for example, you're going to an event, then it's $100 to get you from your house to the event, and then another $100 to get you rent back home. So we don't charge you the time that we're sitting there waiting
for
you
to get
done. Yeah, the small bus and the limo.
Okay.
Are both those prices? So,
okay.
And
it's a good deal, like, if you got, like, that many people, too.
Oh, I know,
yeah.
Right?
Well, bachelorette parties, you know, that's a good deal right there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, let's
you
be real.
I think at IBA.
Well,
yeah.
Most of the girls end up going home with different guys, and you don't even need the party bus, generally speaking, on the way.
You're exactly correct.
I know.
And that's another little girl's story. Well, I do think, though, I mean, for this kind of money, I mean, really.
Yeah, that's wonderful, because some of those other limos are, like, $300 for the night.
Yeah.
That's what
a minimum.
I think.
Mm-hmm. I think last time I did was a minimum three.
Yeah.
And an additional so much per hour.
Wherever you have to go.
Hour afterwards or whatever.
So when you say four for 25 there and back, do you pick them up at different locations?
No, that's all pick up at one location, take them to the bar, and then back to that one location.
Gotcha.
If we have to do additional stops, it's $10 a stop.
That's still very reasonable.
Sure.
But still, if you're taking two couples and you're picking up at two different houses. I mean,
it's
still
fun.
You don't have to worry about who's going to drive, mm-hmm. who's not going to
And this will make all the attorneys out there that make a killing on DUIs very unhappy.
Yes,
however, tell us again quickly, if you don't mind, Triple B's.
Triple B's Express.
Okay.
Is the name of our company.
Okay.
And you can reach us, you know, via Facebook, everything, so.
Okay.
Website.
So the word triple, then B, apostrophe S.
And
yes.
And that's B as in boy.
Boy, yes.
Okay.
Not D as in... Yeah.
Nice.
I was going to say something else than I did, but anyway, it is what it is, right? Okay, we'll be back with another edition of Real People, Real Life. Bye, Mom.
Bye.
Great. That's good.
Alboro Cafe, like a vacation to Italy, with Wichita's best Italian dining. Open Monday to Saturday. Happy hour Monday to Thursday, 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Enjoy our featured cocktails, lovely wines, and famous martinis. Alboro Cafe.
Your home's in your hands, you build it.
Whether building a new home or remodeling, higher quality, lower cost, You Build It is the best value. YouBuildIt.com.
Your home's in your hands, you build it.
Sometimes simplicity is the key. Buying a car should be one of those times. It should be fun, comfortable, and above all, easy. At Economy Motors, we strive to make it just that. We offer a wide variety of vehicles, all priced $12,995 or under, and we've helped people in all types of financial situations with quality cars and easy financing. Is it your turn yet?
Come see us!
Economy Motors, 2305 South Broadway.
Don't worry, because at Economy Motors,
Hammond Liquor, home of the coldest beer in town and the lowest prices store-wide. For all your special events, your friends at Hammond Liquor have what you need, from beer, wines, spirits, champagne, and more. Open till 8 p.m. every Sunday, Hammond Liquor, West Kellogg and Tyler Road.
Credit King Auto Sales is getting better all the time.
King is celebrating 10 years this summer with hot savings, the biggest inventory, and the best deals, plus a party. Credit King Auto Sales, the king of buy here, pay here. No credit, bad credit, no problem. 10-year anniversary savings are going on right now. Don't miss the party May 16th. It's going to be awesome. The King, Credit King, at the King's Corner, 31st South and Broadway. GoCreditKing.com.